So guys, did you go through a meme? I mean, there were a lot of memes coming up these 3 days, three past days. So I just saw this meme that's coming up stating, no entry to India. Indians are busy retweeting behind a tweet. This was the kind of, a board,
Really?
like a hoarding. And I found
Yeah.
this tweet, I found this meme quite interesting. So why don't we talk about that whole meme and we'll just get elaborate on why that meme or what is it surrounding it and
Bro,
all those
have
instances
you
that are
seen this
happening in the
meme?
country. Huh?
I don't know
Which
why.
meme are you talking about, Maria? I
Like,
think today we see
India
different
Gate
memes
only.
every day.
I think the one with the background at India Gate background and one barricade
Of
with
course.
someone
Yes,
must
I
have
think Joel has seen
just
this
Photoshopped
as well.
something there.
Okay, who was the subject of the meme? Was it Mia Khalifa or was it Greta Thunberg or was it
I don't know. It's just that Indians are busy retweeting something. I think it went up with Rihanna's tweet. Maybe the first person who came up with the same. So, like, how far Indians are engaging behind a tweet that came from a person who is, of course, not an Indian, of course. So, we heard a word called, not a word, a paired word called internal matters of the country. We heard something. It's an internal affair of the country, and why should we even entertain somebody who does not even belong to the field of politics, at least, to discuss about something like this? So, what do you guys feel? How far farmers' protest, associated human rights, alleged human rights violation, and all just limit ourselves into internal matter state on one hand, where we all, I mean, every one of us, protested against the Black Lives, I mean, protested with the hashtag Black Lives Matter. We protested, or at least we had a set of discussions about the US presidential elections, all those HR violations that are happening across the world. So how far,
Exactly.
guys, do you guys think
Well,
that internal matter of the state?
when you look at matters like this, I feel like we as a populace, as an Indian population, we're very sensitive. Okay,
Of
and
course.
when it comes to things like we get offended by very little things. Things were going on as normal, you know. There was a fight between the center and the farmers, and it kept going on, kept going on, kept going on. And just when someone from abroad just posted something to show solidarity with the farmers' protest, it blew out of proportion and became something else altogether. If I'm not wrong, I think this was on one news channel, which I was watching, just watching television the other day, and they were exposing Rihanna for past scandals. They even brought Chris Brown to the forefront when he assaulted Rihanna in 2009. I mean, how is all that relevant right now?
See, that's just the rhetoric because, if I don't think any of us like we know about who Rihanna is, but at least those who are tweeting did not know who Rihanna was. So, first thing,
Maybe.
I don't know. Like, see,
Yeah, but
example.
do you think exposing her past, bringing all that to the
Yeah.
forefront now is
Yeah, of
actually
course.
relevant? Forget about Rihanna. Even when Mia Khalifa posted a tweet stating that she's showing solidarity to the farmers' protests, she got backlash for being in the porn industry.
Of course. And the kind of slut shaming that came up against every single woman who
Exactly.
reacted, I think that's the worst phase
Forget
one can
about that.
imagine,
Even
right?
Greta Thunberg, no matter what you say about her, is a little child at the end of the day.
Hey, she's our age only.
People, whatever that is, she's a little child to, like, you know, at least if you look at it in a world perspective, people look at her as a little child, an environmentalist or whatever you call her. Even then, people are burning pictures of her in India, calling her all sorts of things, giving her rape threats,
Yes,
death
video of
threats.
the pictures
What is
are
the point of all
matters.
this?
See,
Few
but
of
the images are gone.
yeah, but I
Yes.
feel, see, some matters, unless you have a little pride, I'm not saying that I did not comment. Twitter is a place for it's a place for commenting about something which you really feel is most important at. But then it's like with regard to internal matter, see, internal matter should be something with regard to intelligence or national security and safety or some kind of program that's actually happening in the state. But the most funny aspect, the most orchestrated aspect, not funny, orchestrated aspect was when the celebrities, several celebrities who came in and said, we need to find an amicable solution, India against propaganda, India against.
I saw that. And I
Celebrity.
think even Sachin Tendulkar was the one who got a lot of flack for that, right?
Yeah,
Of
because
Akshay Kumar,
there is a
Sachin
context. There is a context for Sachin, there's actually a context because I think Maria Sharapova, when someone asked her, do you know who Sachin is, she said, I don't know. So then people are trolling her, then you don't know who he is. Now they're like, oh, sorry, we now realize our mistake.
And half of the celebrities who came up with the wording amicable solution were those people who never ever reacted in their whole life in political matters. They were like a couple of people who never even, you know, dared to speak a word against what's happening in the country. And like at one fortnight, we could see everybody with hashtags, India sovereignty cannot be, what was it? India sovereignty cannot be broken. Okay, fine. Okay, I'll keep all these things aside.
I don't think you can deny that the campaign was pretty orchestrated. Like example, in one particular day, you won't have all three of them, be it Mia Khalifa or be it Getta or even be it Meena Harrison, and several people commenting about farm protest or the internet issue.
So what are you trying to say, Joel? Like someone is influencing them to post, you know? And coming to that point, I think there were allegations against an organization in Canada, which is, I think, the Poetic Justice Foundation, if I'm not wrong. And allegedly, they paid Rihanna a huge sum of money to actually post this tweet. What do you think about that?
Celebrities paid a chunk for a tweet. I'm not talking about this tweet, but then they usually paid for tweets. Celebrities are paid. Like big brand.
We should also think about that aspect as well, Minaj. But see, in the beginning and all, these kind of allegations went about to be funny because the amount of money people said she would have been paid was $10,000 or maybe 1 lakh for Rihanna to bring out
nothing,
a tweet.
Nothing beats Congress Neta, Congress Kisan Neta Rihanna. That is the
oh my god, that was just something else.
ये फार्मर है इनको एमएसपी जानता है इनको फार्म बिल जानता है लाइक दैट एंटायर 24 आवर्स जस्ट वेंट ऑफ विद दैट बट एट लीस्ट लाइक वी शुडंट पे अटेंशन टू नॉइज वी शुड पे अटेंशन टू व्हाट्स रियली हैपनिंग बिकॉज़ इट्स बीन मोर देन 60 डेज लाइक या बीन मोर देन 2-3 मंथ्स सिंस दे हैव बीन स्टेइंग इन द बॉर्डर्स एंड नाइदर इज देयर एनी काइंड ऑफ रेप्रिहेंशन विद रिगार्ड टू व्हाट टू डू बट आई थिंक
सी एग्जैक्टली And despite having so many rounds of dialogue between the farmers and the state, they haven't even reached an amicable solution between the two parties. So,
see, but the government had offered to stay the laws for 18 months. But then the point on the one side is that why, like, because of the 26 January violence, what happened, it kind of weakened the movement. Like some unions also backed out of the movement also. Because
it went about to be looked in a suspicion. In a greater stance than how it was checked at. Because already we had all those Khalistani claims that were made against the movement from the very beginning. Like undeniably, it's a very exposed truth. Like undeniably, people went about to say the Khalistani relations. And even I just went through a news report that came in Economic Times as well, where they said that Canadian think tanks have identified that the Khalistani, all those claims that are coming up right now is heavily funded from Pakistan.
That is one.
So they went about to say that it would affect the security of both countries, India and Canada as well. So identifying that even the Poetry Justice Foundation to be, okay, I forgot his name. Joel, you remember his name? I just told you.
Aman, I think.
Editor-in-chief of PJF. Okay. This is also stated that he is the one. Okay, of course, we should not forget to discuss about the current thing that's on fire out of what was tweeted by the toolkit, the Farmers Protest Toolkit, which was first of all tweeted, then taken back, then again retweeted after corrections from the part of Greta Thunbergian. So, at the end of the day, people are trying, not people as per se, the whole external affairs ministry is trying to find out what is that hidden agenda or propaganda or strategy behind all of a sudden national outbreak. So do you guys have a feeling that the ultimate claim they're coming up with is the human rights violation that's happening in the border with all those, barricades being popping up, those stone made, all those things that are being placed on the road, cutting off of electricity connection, water connection, even internet connection also. So what do you guys feel with the human rights aspect of it?
Well, even if you look at the human rights aspect of it, you have to look at it. You look at how the whole matter materialized both ends. First, it was so-called peaceful protest, and it went on like that for quite some time. And then when the protest turned violent, the police had to obviously use appropriate measures to counteract that violence that was being brought about. So many police vehicles were damaged, so many policemen were injured, public property was damaged, and like Jewel stated earlier, even on the 26th of January on Republic Day, when, you know, everyone is looking forward to celebrating that day as a nation's pride, there was violence, and then they infiltrated the Red Fort, and then they hoisted a flag next to the Republic flag, the Indian flag. And I mean, when you take all those things into context, I feel like, you know, it completely lost steam there. And it wasn't about the farm bills anymore. There was some other agenda behind it.
Yeah, because...
Yeah, for sure.
All throughout that entire day, there was the propaganda that they removed the Indian flag from the place and they put a Khalistani flag. Though there was a video of, like, when that man was approaching the pole and putting the Nissan Sahib. It's a religious flag. It's not exactly a Khalistani flag. It's not a Khalistani flag. But then when someone offered him the Indian flag to put, he threw it away. There was a video of that. But then they never removed any flag from there. But then there was the allegation, like, okay, it is the Khalistani flag and things. But all
the kind of instigations, exactly, Joel, like just he pointed out. Like, if you remember on 26th itself, once this incident, you know, once everything went about, you know, super problematic in exclusive, you know, I have no clue how to explain it. The first news that came up to all of us was it was the Khalistani flag. So, see, imagine the kind of gravity an issue of that sort has. A separatist flag is getting hoisted in the national monument, irrespective of the extensive security we have at a capital state city. So all these things have something burning behind, which one cannot basically untwirl so easily.
See, there's
let's not even delve into what the media has done throughout this entire protest, because that's just shameful.
The
I have no words for that
aspect to it. Like, if you see in history as well, like, I'm not saying it's justifying the entire putting up the flag of the Khalsa, like the Nishan Sahib flag. But then in like when you saw in 1783, there was a Sikh warrior called Baghel Singh, Sardar Baghel Singh. He defeated the Mughals and he actually unfurled the flag there. And it's known today as the Fateh Diwas. So I think 2014, there was one such event which happened. So it's actually a very historical movement. But then it's very, you can't really justify it by saying, okay, it's symbolic, so we go and hoist the flag. A, it's actually a religious flag. And B, it's a national monument, so you can't, it's an aspect of secular fabric of the country as such. So that's why you can't really replace something as what you create as sacrosanct national importance as such. So I don't think that really made the movement very weak. And the intelligence failure also was one particular thing. You think no one knew that, you know, they would be coming and over and unfurling the flag and things like that. It's, I don't know, it's a little skeptical as such.
And also with respect to the international, intervention. See, if you check into Rihanna's post, what you would find would be one statement that said, why aren't we talking about this? # farmers protest. So that was the one thing I could find in that post. Like, I just thought in every way I could, but that's the only angle I could find. But in the farmer's toolkit that came up from the side of Greta, it suspected that, okay, I forgot his name before. It was Mo Dhaniwal, who is the co-founder of Poetry Justice Foundation and a pro-Khalistani group, is suspected to have prepared the farmer's toolkit and would have provided to Greta Thunberg. And the obviously, India is investigating what has actually, you know, who has actually, that's why we heard about FIR being filed against Greta and all those things that are happening. See, to an extent, understand the point that, such interventions value a lot because people across the globe look forth a lot into these celebrity posts and tweets. You know, the number of people who like, comment and share these kind of posts. There's a huge influence that these celebrities can create. Even in India, we know what Kangana Ranaut had been posting for a long time. Like, you would have seen a series of tweets coming up. And all those, the kind of wordings, the language that is being used. I don't know how far they'll, justify them. Because I even heard another meme which said, I just told to Joy also, a meme that said that Kangana is allegedly to be paid 12.5 crore for not tweeting anything.
Oh,
so that's the...
Yeah. If I'm not wrong, she called the farmers terrorists, right?
Yes.
And Twitter also removed those tweets.
See, the
government... Yeah, Twitter even suspended a tweet even reported a tweet that came today. Okay, I think today only, that cricketers as dogs. They went about to call cricketers as dogs.
I think Rohit.
Wow.
See, like, I don't think we should pay attention to her tweets. Neither should the government should have paid attention to Rihanna or Mia Khalifa, because those are just treat them as noise if you want. Don't really treat them as important. It became even more worse when you treat them as very important and got into her history, her domestic, her abuse, and that's how it became more and more worse. Like, you have the IT cell and you have everybody jumping into it.
If you treat
it as noise, it would have been noise at the end of the day. Same with Kangana.
Like, how do we have time for all these things, yaar? How do we have time for all these things?
We are the country with the lowest employment. Unemployment is at a low height. So we need something to employ us.
Joel, you're taking a dig at your own country, man.
Employment, man. Employment. Somewhere you need to get employment. If you're getting paid by tweets, it's also better.
Okay, well, maybe on a serious note, where do you think this is all heading, guys? What do you think is the next step?
Even the government has been treating these, because if you compare it to the previous CAA protests also, actually over here you're having talks with the government, and even though several leaders of the government had told, okay, yeah, Khalistani, etc. You had Rajnath Singh over that, no, they actually laid our lives for the Hindus, and they also laid lives. Historically also, the Sikhs have very strong ties with the Hindus, and also with India in particular. Like you had Guru Tegh Bahadur also sacrificed his life also, but when Aurangzeb killed him.
So, and even if you look at it, Sikhs are considered as Hindus in India.
Under the Hindu law, like you're treated
at least the personal laws governed.
Yeah, at least the
personal laws. Yeah, exactly.
It's a very historically tied relationship. Like, even when you saw that, like what happened in Punjab in the insurgency period was that you had the entire Khalistani narrative, Bhindranwale coming into the entire scene. And they were demanding for a separate state, etc. And also, you had instances of wherein Hindus were killed also in the state as well.
Yeah.
It became even more worse when it was the right thing, like, because he was hiding in the Golden Temple, and they had to remove him some way, but then it was not justified that, the way they went in and they damaged several parts of the Holy Temple. So that caused a lot of outrage, and you had the bodyguards killing Indira Gandhi, and the Blue Star. That's what I was saying. The Blue Star was wherein they came to the Golden Temple to bring out Bhindranwale outside. So then they damaged some parts of the temple as well. Like, it's like considering your holy places. No, like, example, if someone will go and damage, I'm saying theoretically Mecca or Jerusalem also, the outrage will be a lot more worse. I'm not justifying the fact that
it can affect a lot of emotions.
Yeah, it's a lot of emotional aspects. So that's why the bodyguards killed her. And then I think all of us are very, very, very young, because that time Doordarshan was
आज सवेरे नई दिल्ली में प्रधानमंत्री के निवास स्थान पर श्रीमती गांधी की हत्या करने की कोशिश की गई. उन्हें तुरंत ऑल इंडिया इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ मेडिकल साइंसेज ले जाया गया. वहां पहुंचते ही डॉक्टरों ने उनका उपचार शुरू कर दिया.
आकाशवाणी वार्ताक വായിക്കുന്നത് ഗോപൻ. പ്രധാനമന്ത്രി ശ്രീമതി ഇന്ദിരാഗാന്ധി നിര്യാതയായ വിവരം ഞങ്ങൾ വ്യസനസമേതം അറിയിക്കുന്നു. നമ്പർ 1 സഫ്ദർജംഗ് റോഡിലെ തന്റെ ഔദ്യോഗിക വസതിയിൽ സ്വന്തം അംഗരക്ഷകരിലൊരാളുടെ വെടിയേൽക്കുകയായിരുന്നു. ഉടൻ തന്നെ ആശുപത്രിയിൽ എത്തിച്ചെങ്കിലും മണിക്കൂറുകളോളം ശ്രമിച്ചിട്ടും ജീവൻ രക്ഷിക്കാനായില്ല. അങ്ങനെ ഇന്ദിര പ്രിയദർശിനി കഥാവശേഷയായി. ലോകരാജ്യങ്ങളുടെ ഭൂപടത്തിൽ ഇന്ത്യയ്ക്കൊരു സുപ്രധാന സ്ഥാനം നേടിക്കൊടുത്ത ഭാരതത്തിന്റെ പ്രിയപുത്രിയുടെ ദാരുണമായ അന്ത്യം ലോകജനതയെ ആകെ ഞടുക്കി. ലോക നേതാക്കൾ ഭാരതത്തിന്റെ ഈ തീരാനഷ്ടത്തിൽ അഗാധമായ ദുഃഖവും ഞടുക്കവും പ്രകടിപ്പിച്ചു.
Do you think bringing that religious angle into a protest like this, which is majorly concerns the farmers, is actually appropriate?
See, Minnaj, like, answering your first question also, like, what is the option that we have in front of us, is that if I am asked the question, I'll tell you, your mentality has to change. If all you want is to put some religious tinge to everything, a terrorist tinge to everything, and start judging even a tweet, I don't think that's going to help in the progress of the country. Like, I never deny the fact that when farmers protest toolkit is something that requires investigation, because there is something problematic and instigative in that content. I agree. I 100% agree. But for tweets, like, why aren't we talking about this? See, it's her freedom to tweet something that she feels. It's her opinion. She never said on behalf of right wing. She never said against anything against right wing. It's all about she addressed, tried to address a protest, which is inclusive of some sort of human rights violation as alleged. So, see, taking a, you know, a kind of closing eyes and justifying your means does not find solutions for everything. So that's the only point I have at hand right now. Joel, if you have to, if you wish to answer his question as well.
See, how do you stop a protest? First thing, attack the roots. Like, when something really happens, like example, someone is protesting against you. Now, how do you stop it? Either you go at him and say, okay, you've been misguided, you have been wrongly told about the law, or you tell them, okay, you're being paid, you are an agent, and you're getting things like that. So somewhere or the other, the aspect does come when the religious aspect does come in picture, when, like, in order to stop the protest. Because when you saw the protest, majority of them were from Punjab and Haryana. Now you're having the protest more in the Ghazipur border than Rakesh
Tikhara. Exactly, more Jats involved now.
More Jats involved. So now that becomes a more thing, because Jats are a major part of the vote bank of the parties respectively. So then if you have mobilization and things, you had the violence which happened with 2016, I guess there was a violence. There has to be some kind of a solution in order to bring this down. But again, the government, because reforms are very hard to put in this country. That's one thing which...
Absolutely. And I think one thing that really needs to take place now is the government needs to take up the responsibility to actually explain the laws.
Hmm.
Actually tell the farmers that, okay, you know what? The laws that we're actually putting into force are not that bad for you. They're actually for your own benefit. Because even when you look at the leaders of these farmers' unions, they've just taken up a cause and gone marched towards Delhi to protest for no goddamn reason, knowing what the actual problem is.
No, like they know the central idea. They want to make MSP statutory and they want to repeal the law.
They want a separate legislation for MSP.
Joel, do you think all that information is actually being conveyed?
See, like one thing, like if you look at these acts as standalone, these are actually reform acts. Like we had discussion earlier with Sumuk also. It had some really good point with regard to like how you can't be restricted to one APMC. You can actually sell it outside, etc., etc. Now it depends on the area. Now if you just pass it off in the Rajya Sabha and no discussion and things like that. So if that things really happen, then people will think, okay, you're trying to push something into it, and people will either they go statewide and say, do you want to implement this act? And obviously there will be some states who want to implement it also. Like, don't implement, like, either the government should be thinking that, okay, let's not implement it in Haryana and Punjab. Maybe implement it in other states where they want it. And seeing this and how it grows, the Punjab and Haryana farmers will automatically come to them and tell, okay, we want the laws to come into our land.
Joel, I don't think I agree with that point, Joel. If there's something that has to be implemented, it has to be uniform.
Uniform, agreed. Like,
example, because think about it, there's several provisions even within this act where interstate selling of produce is also encouraged, where farmers from one state can sell in the APMC in mandis and other states as well. So when you think about those, aspects of it, you need a unilateral enforcement of such an act so that everyone is, you know, aware about this and the implementation is uniform throughout the country.
See,
otherwise, it would lead to a lot of disparity.
You know, I understood Joel's point also there, because understanding the fact that only dissembling the dissembling how it's going to be mandated or how it's going to be initiated, you know, in all the states uniformly can be problematic. I think this can be found to be a solution, but that's not eternal. At the end of the day, you can only keep it for a temporary.
They will come back, like seeing some, like example,
of course,
Subramanian Swami had told a few days back, like implemented in other place, whichever wants it. Example, there will be farmers who had actually come forward and tell, okay, we want the laws. So when they see the growth over there, first thing, agriculture is a state subject. Government came in through a trade and commerce, and because that's a more interstate thing, because agriculture is solely a state subject. But then if they really want to push in this reform, it's actually a good reform, because what you're seeing in Punjab and Haryana and all, that like several scientists have been saying that they're actually using a lot of water for the crops and all those things. So they need to change the crops as such. So those aspects, only if you pass, if you be more gentle and pass it more democratically rather than just a voice note in the parliament and things like that, people will be actually appreciating these reforms. Because who knows, these actually good reforms, who knows?
Or do you think it's possible to have like a trial period of implementation where the laws are actually tested for maybe a year or 2 years to see if, you know, to assess the possible pros and cons of the act in reality. So, and then, you know, the states can actually come to a consensus about whether they want to implement
it. Again, it has to be after the period in which it's suspended by the Supreme Court. It has to finish first.
Taking that into consideration as well.
Yeah. And moreover, see, if any person with a normal rational comes up and sees, okay, even after 8 rounds of talk among the farming, the groups in the government, it does not work, simply means that the approach you're using is not right. See, from the part of the whatever approach that has been utilized, it's not right. Simply pelting stones each other won't help. Creating cement barricades, creating all those thorns and all on the road, not giving them water, not giving them medicine, does not work. It's all about the way that we approach, and vice versa as well. I'm not speaking all about against the government, but vice versa as well. Farmers have to either give off their ears to, you know, get to know what the real thing is, and then express their problem. Until and unless things of this type matter, I don't think it will help a lot for at least a good period of time.
Yeah.
What we want to discuss over here, and since this is ongoing, I think we just need to keep our eyes and ears open, wait for more happenings in this particular protest, and, you know, see if anyone else from abroad has something to say about this.
And like you can't deny that there are some fringe elements who are there in Canada and UK are trying to...
In any protest, Joel, this isn't the only one. If you think about the CAA protest or any other protest that happened in our history, there's always been some sort of fringe element involved. But that shouldn't, sway us from looking at the actual crux of the matter.
I'm just saying, let's not go back to 84 when those thousands of Sikhs were actually killed, and like our entire atmosphere was so bad for the entire country as such. Like, I think Rajiv Gandhi also told that when a big tree falls, the earth shakes. Like when Indira Gandhi falls, the Sikhs will get disturbed. So, like those kind of things, it's sounding a very it's actually ringing a bell today also. Like people are accusing them of being Khalistani, anti-this, anti-that. I think there should be some really good dialogue and some solution, at least for the temporary being. And the farmers should really hold it on because before there was no politicians in the entire scene. Now you're seeing politicians also come inside the rallies trying to help the farmers. Mm-hmm. Now that are becoming more political and more caste-based as such. That's why. That's one thing we should stop.
And like I stated...
Go ahead.
Yeah, like I stated earlier, since the laws are now suspended for a period of, I think, 12 months, right? Or how much? 2 years?
18 months.
So since it's been suspended for a period of that time, I feel like now the actual dialogue should come into play where, you know, there's clarifications and all of that going on. So when it actually is implemented, there isn't any backlash and both the parties are happy.
And also, as a final remark, next time you post something, you get sentimental like anything, just read into it and try to address it politically if it's a political statement, rather than going behind their history, going behind their family tree and making a mess out of it. Please don't go below your standards. Just check what's there in front of you, read it twice, and then go ahead to make a response. Rather than simply, you know, bringing out filthy comments and irritating them, just stop doing that. Okay, I'm not using the word. Stop doing that and just... And also adding on Minaj, like for all those people who are like super good reactors, super active in social media and all, it's great to have that. It's great to socialize. It's great to understand what's happening around you. But before you comment something on a person's back, or a person's past, or a person's background or whatever it is, something that's really sensitive, please think twice. Please understand what is the content of that person's whatever it is, a message or whatever the case be, and something that is not really that makes you happy. It's fine. It's not that they can beat you at your house. It's just that they have commented their opinion. Just try to be tolerant, you know, more than what we are today. And that can, I think, resolve a major chunk of issues right now we have at hand. And yeah, anything else, guys?
Yeah, that pretty much sums it. Minaj, you want to say anything?
Yes. No, that's pretty much it.
Yeah, so.
So Joel, our maybe our tagline. Argument of podcast.
So thank you so much.
Yeah, Joel, missed your voice. No introduction like before, huh?
Yeah. Yes. Right.
Thank you so much for tuning into Argumenta Podcast. Finally, we're going to a video podcast after so many times trying to try my team members into coming into the video. So kudos
our
to
fans making want happen. Our faces.
Yeah.
I don't think anyone's really keen on seeing our faces, bro.
Yeah. Okay. Thank you so much for tuning into Argumenta Podcast once again. You can tune into our podcast on Spotify, YouTube. And also shortened versions in IGTV and other platforms as well. Stay tuned to our next episode. You can also drop in your recommendations as well in the comment box. Also DM us as well. And stay tuned.
And if any one of you wish to join us for a podcast, for a discussion on any topic, please feel free to DM us. We're open to ideas and we're open to having you guys on the podcast as well.
Yeah, that's
we'll amazing. Really appreciate amazing collaborations. We really want to hear your opinions as well. So consider this to be the best stage for that. And yes, bye.
See ya.